I honestly don't think a single video I put out from CES didn't include some form of this question. Hey, Caleb, any news on QDEL? And to be fair, in my CES preview video, I did tease that I had news about QDEL. But as you've probably noticed by now, I've been silent about it. And well, there's a story behind that. And I'm happy to report that that story ends with QDEL having made far more progress than I'd expected. But should we still be excited? I mean, between the advancements we saw in OLED panels and mini LED backlighting technology, does QDEL still have its own chapter in the annals of display advancement? Or will it end up being more of a footnote? Let's talk about that. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Caleb Dennison, and let's do a quick QDEL catch-up, shall we? So QDEL is another annoying tech acronym that stands for Quantum Dot Electroluminescent. What it is, in practical terms, is a display made up of quantum dots that make light when you apply electricity to them. Right now, if you hear about quantum dots in your TV, they're usually tiny nanoparticles that glow a certain color when you shine light on them. They glow sympathetically. That's what's happening in a QD OLED or quantum dot OLED TV. You have blue OLED lights shining on quantum dots that glow red or green in response to that blue light being shown on them. And thus you get an RGB display. In an LCD-based display, like an LED or mini LED backlit TV, the quantum dots help make very bright, near perfect white light, which expands the color gamut and color volume of those TVs. But again, in that scenario, they're like helpers. They don't make their own light. In a QDEL display though, or nano LED if you insist, the quantum dot nanoparticles make their own light. So in many ways, a QDEL display is gonna have all the benefits of an OLED display, but with none of the drawbacks, or at least that's the dream. Perfect blacks, exacting color, high color brightness, instant pixel response time, all without the risk of burn-in and with a presumably much longer lifespan than OLED. Now, the display nerd community, of which I am a proud card-carrying member, has been looking forward to QDEL since the tech was floated as a possibility. But it wasn't until last year at CES 2024 that the public ever saw it in action. And that's because I got let into a secret back room at the last second to see a prototype that was not being shown to the public. You may have seen that video. It was all very exciting. So naturally, folks like you were eager to hear and see if any developments had been made. And well, I was afraid I was gonna have to share some disappointing news. Ahead of CES, I spoke to one of my sources who had said that there had been major progress with QDEL displays, and in fact, that there were three panel manufacturers working on it. But despite reaching out and assuring these folks I would do a good job reporting about it, they remained skittish. See, these display manufacturing arms don't have PR and marketing firms quite like the consumer electronics companies I deal with do. They aren't interested in showing to consumers. What they want to do is get electronics companies to buy their stuff, and only when it's ready. And so I thought I was gonna have to tell you that there was progress on QDEL, but that nobody would show it to me, so you'd just have to take my word for it. And then, well then, again, at the last possible second, I found out that there was a QDEL display on the show floor, right smack in the middle of the central hall at the Las Vegas Convention Center, hiding in plain sight. And because CES is so massive and folks are busy gawking at giant TVs and robot vacuums, it would seem that nobody caught it, including me. But once I was tipped off by my source, I sent someone there to shoot video of it, and well, here it is. What you're seeing right now is a QDEL display at work in a 14-inch laptop, tucked away in a far corner of TCL CSOT's display within TCL's much larger and frankly distracting electronics booth. Now, I don't know about you, but I think that screen is looking pretty dang good, especially compared to the super early prototype that we saw last year. For sure, we are several steps closer to seeing a TV-sized QDEL screen prototype. And once that happens, A QDEL TV could be right around the corner. Now, we didn't get very many photos or very long B-roll, so you'll have to pardon us repeating things a bit. But now you've seen it and you know it exists. And I think that's pretty stinking exciting. But let's set the excitement over seeing something new and innovative aside for a moment and ask some real practical questions. I mean, we saw both WOLED and QD-OLED panels make another really big jump in brightness at CES this year. Up to 3,700 nits peak from a new four-layer OLED display that we can safely assume comes from LG Display, as implemented in Panasonic's upcoming Z95B TV, and probably the LG G5 as well, although LG wouldn't say. There's also a new 4,000 nit peak, 400 nit full screen QD OLED panel from Samsung Display. So, like, do we still need QDEL? I would argue, yes, we do. See, as awesome as OLED is and is still becoming, it's still based on organic compounds, which means that there's always gonna be some lingering burn-in risk and it's gonna have a somewhat limited lifespan. Although honestly, those aren't real issues for most people. Actually, the real issue for TV buyers like you is cost. OLED TVs are expensive to make. The OLED manufacturing process is involved and costly, and that really hasn't changed a bunch over the past few years. And perhaps most importantly, large screen OLED TVs are prohibitively expensive. Meanwhile, 98-inch LCD TVs are going for as little as $1,500 on sale. Like, they just can't compete at the large screen level. What QDEL means for the future is OLED-like performance, in some measures better than OLED, but with no burn-in risk, a much longer lifespan, the ability to perform well in extreme heat and cold, and the least sexy but arguably most important factor is it's not very expensive to make. Now, you may have also heard about some new approaches to using quantum dots, like ultraviolet micro LED excited quantum dots. And yeah, I find the concept of that technology super intriguing as well. But there's a lot to iron out with that technology too. Micro LED printing techniques may see some big improvements in the coming years, but something tells me that QDEL could come to market a little earlier than anything with micro LED attached to its name. So yeah, I think that QDEL is very relevant and remains extremely exciting. I honestly think that if there's any display technology that could unseat LCD's dominance in the TV space, it's QDEL. Now, normally at this point in the video, I'd say something like, guess we'll have to wait until next January to learn more, but I'm hoping that that won't be the case this year because I plan on visiting the Display Week conference in May. And it is there that I think that we'll be seeing a bit more from QDEL. And we might even get more info on how it's coming along. So there you go. QDEL has made some meaningful progress. It's still extremely promising, even among all these other advancements in existing display technologies. And we might learn even more just in a few months. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. What do you think of how QDEL is progressing so far? Let me know down in the comments. And if you found this video informative and entertaining, click that thumbs up button and subscribe to keep up on the latest in TVs and TV tech. I'll see you on the next one. And until then, here's two other videos I think you might like. Oh my, it's an amateur.